starry, starry night. Paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills. Sketch the trees and the daffodils. Catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on the snowy linen.
Morning, Mrs. Fuqua. How are you?
I'm fine, Mr. Ackerman.
Why are you being so formal, Tessa? What's the big deal, man? Don and I have known you guys since the 90s. When did you came to Pueblo in the mid to late 90s? When did you guys?
We moved there in 98, and we looked for a vineyard church because we'd been part of the vineyard movement for several years. And wow, right away we saw you guys listed somewhere. And I think within 2 weeks we were leading worship at the church. And you guys. Yeah. I mean, there were 7 vineyards in the Houston area, so we would gather together pretty regularly, corporately like that. Yeah.
And that was Bert Wagoner's. He was kind of the lead of that set of vineyards, or?
Yeah, of the Houston area, I think so. We have very different backgrounds. Mine is Catholic and John is Southern Baptist. And then I became Southern Baptist along the way, and we got married in the Baptist church. And after we had our first child, Michaela, we just really felt like we wanted something that was more just for us, our family. How did we want to do it? You know, we didn't really know all the terms, like, how are we going to worship, blah, blah, blah. We just were like, let's find something. And again, we just looked like on the phone book or somewhere. And we were like, you know what? This church is close to where we live. And we knew it was like non-denominational. We didn't know that much about the vineyard. So we visited and it was like home right away. Like they embraced us. We began to do different groups, and John began to play actually congas on the worship team after a little while. And I was just kind of doing stuff with the women and with the kids for quite a while until they found out that I could also play and sing. But I still remember when we went to talk, the pastor's like, you want to, be part of this? And Michaela was a baby and we had her and we're talking in his office. And I was like, yeah, but I don't really sing. And Michaela pipes up. She goes, you sing all the time, mommy. Because every night we were singing like before we go to bed, and praying. And that was kind of the start of me going, yeah, I do sing.
Were you a strong Catholic or were you more of a nominal Catholic or somewhere in between?
Our family was very much part of the Catholic community. I have actually a lot of positive things to say about being Catholic. I don't agree with, some of their theology, some of the tenets of the bottom line. It's about Jesus and he's a salvation. And I see that. But there are a lot of things I actually appreciate more even now as an older person, as far as the liturgy goes, that it actually has real meaning,
Right. I believe there's one church, all who are in Christ. And, and I love it that the church is kind of getting over itself. And even within the vineyard, that we really embrace some of this Catholic spirituality, specifically Ignatian practices.
We're one body and we all have our faults and our probably our false beliefs and practices in the different groups or denominations.
Yeah. Our idols. Yeah.
Totally. Yeah.
And sometimes it's easier to see somebody else's idols. So you're married to John. How long have you guys been married together?
We just celebrated our 35th wedding anniversary on the August 13th. Before that, we were together for 7 years. We met as teenagers in high school, and then we got married after we graduated from college.
That's cool. What did you study in college?
I was basically a business major, economics management, that type of thing.
Are you sure about that? Because that doesn't, business economics doesn't seem to fit with what I see on the wall behind you right now.
So I once took a test that showed I was almost equally left brain and right brain. And so I felt like that explained why I did the business economics thing and went into law after college. And then at the same time, I still always had this very like loose vibe and creativity and
yeah, because it sure seems like you're slightly higher on the creative side. right now.
I think maybe later in life, because those are the pursuits that right. I have. But early on, and even now, though, I'm very I don't like to be without structure, and I do actually analyze things beforehand. Yeah. As far as logistics, can I do that? You know, if I'm asked to do some event or create something, and I actually also think about what I'm going to put on the canvas, whatever it looks like. I actually spend probably more time thinking, maybe 90% thinking about it and visualizing.
That's amazing.
And then I physically create very quickly. So, yeah.
Yeah. Now, is John much more on the creative side, or is he a little bit of both also?
You know, I think because he's had to play the role of working in a certain industry, he's in the IT industry. Okay. He worked for NASA as a network engineer. He's basically still a network engineer, even throughout all the different companies he's worked. If he had had if God had given him that margin, I actually think he's more of the creative. Mm-hmm. That
unfortunately, we have to survive and make a living. And engineering is a pretty good way to make a living, I would imagine. So so you actually practiced law for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about that.
20s, yeah. So let's see. In my 20s, I went to law school. We had our first kid, and I practiced law. I began practice law for a nonprofit, and also did like a part-time solo practice. Hmm. And then when Isaac, our second child, was born, I stopped practicing law completely shortly after that. So we started to homeschool and just kind of do a lot more things in the church, I guess, too. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and it's just been a long process of God, actually, I feel like, releasing in me just permission to create and do things, you know, differently, you know. And throughout the years, you know, throughout the different periods of my life, you know, the little kids, the bigger kids, one last kid left at home now, that he's slowly opened it up in ways I never would have imagined, you know.
And how you tried to set them free, they would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never